All right, we're going to talk about the different ways that you can determine the heart rate. There are several different methods. The first one that's the easiest is the 6-second method. Now, you need to really pay attention to this. You need to make sure that the strip is a 6-second strip for this method. This is critical. If it's not, this is not going to work. Okay? So, remember we talked about the little notch up at the top? Well, this is 3 seconds, and then so this is 3 seconds. So this is a 6-second strip. So we can use this method with this particular strip, okay? And then each large square, remember, the time in seconds is 0.2, and the amplitude is 5 millimeters, okay? So what you're gonna do is you're just going to count the number of R waves. Remember, this is QRS, right? This is the R wave. You're just going to count the number of them. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the heart rate is 70 beats per minute. Now you can do the same exact thing with the P waves. Because remember, the P waves indicate atrial depolarization. So this is when the atria are firing. So you just count the number of P waves. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the atrial rate is 70 as well. Now the next method is called large squares. Alrighty, so you want to count the number of large squares between the two R waves, okay? And so if you count them, there's 1, 2, 3, there are 4 of them. All right, now remember, there are 300 large squares in 60 seconds. There are 30 large squares in a 6-second strip, and you need to multiply both of those by 10. That's where we get the 300. Okay? Now, to get the heart rate using this method, you take 300 and divide it by the number of large squares between each R wave. Okay? And that'll give you the heart rate. So ours, we take 300 divided by 4. The heart rate here is 75 beats per minute. Now, if you'll notice, this is a 5-second strip, and it doesn't matter, okay? So this is the correct heart rate. All right, now, also with the large squares, this is called the sequence method because there's a sequence involved. Now, I don't particularly care for this because with this, you have to memorize these numbers. But if that works for you, this is a very good way of doing this. Again, you don't need a 6-second strip in this one, okay? So remember that 300 divided by the number of large squares between the R's is going to give you the heart rate, okay, in beats per minute. Now, so if you have 1 square in between the R waves, it's going to be 300 because 300 divided by 1 is 300. If they're 2 squares, it's going to be 150 because 300 divided by 2 is 150, so forth and so on. Ours, we have 4, so 300 divided by 4 is 75, so there's ours, okay? And then 5 and then 6. The last one we're going to talk about are the small squares. It's done the same way, but instead of counting large squares, you're going to count the small squares. Okay? Now remember, there are 5 small squares in each large square, right? So 5, 10, 15, 20. We have 20 small squares. There are 1,500 small squares in 60 seconds. There's 150 small squares in 6 seconds, multiply them both by 10. So you take 1,500 and divide that by the number of small squares between the two R waves, and that gives you the heart rate. Again, this is ventricular. You can do the same thing with the P waves for the atrial rate. 1500 divided by 20 equals 75 beats per minute. And that's it.